You'll hear a lot about Android devices, but that's just a small part of what Android really is.
When you think about a device, like an Android device, that's a gizmo. That's a thing. You can go to the store. You can buy that.
There are a ton of devices out there on the shelf or whatever, and you know, maybe someday each one of those would be running Android. You know, they all look different. They all, you know, would cost different. They could be a bunch of different things. They'd all be made by different people. But you know, one of our goals would be to just get Android all over the place. And you know, we've done that in a bunch of different ways, mostly by making it so that it's really easy for the industry to adopt. We've made it free. You don't have to license it. We've done a lot of work making sure that this platform is viable to the industry. Manufacturers and carriers are more likely to adopt the whole platform. We make it easy for developers to extend the platform to make sure that it stays, you know, on the cutting edge of the industry. In developing Android or developing something like this, you know, there's always this tension between a product and a platform.
A platform is what enables you to make all of those things.
As we've built the Android platform, we've spent a lot of time thinking about how it's going to be used in the future.
There are several layers in the Android system. It's a complete software stack.
We've got the Linux kernel, the system libraries, Dalvik, the application framework, and then all of the applications on top of that.
The Linux kernel has been around for many, many years. It's tried and true. It's used in millions of computers and devices, but it hasn't really been thoroughly optimized for mobile devices. So what we did was we worked on power management, we worked on a new shared memory driver, we worked on this thing we call the binder, which is this lightweight IPC mechanism, and we did work on just on the scheduler to really make it work efficiently for a small device.
We pulled a lot of libraries in from the open source community, big ones like WebKit and Harmony, OpenSSL,
the Apache HTTP components, and ICU.
In addition to a lot of the other open source libraries that Android uses, we're open sourcing a bunch of new libraries as part of the Android platform.
Among the things that we wrote ourselves were a bunch of media codecs, so for sound and video.
We have graphics libraries,
2D and 3D graphics, and speech recognition.
Dalvik is a new virtual machine that was designed by Dan that was intended to be on these mobile devices.
It was designed to deal well in a memory-constrained and CPU-constrained environment where you're operating off of battery power.
The application framework makes it easy for application developers to use all the different pieces of a mobile device. You know, you're going to have things like the screen, maybe a touch screen, a trackball, the buttons, a GPS.
And of course, the platform really wouldn't be complete without some applications, and so we've built them. We've included a web browser, an email client, instant messaging, a camera for the phone, a dialer, contacts, and the list goes on.
At every layer of the platform, we put in hooks to make it so that people can extend it in ways that we never even thought of. We've partnered with kernel.org to host the source, and we built tools to help developers interact with the source. We're using Git as the source control system, but we built a bunch of tools on top of it to make it a lot easier to deal with a platform as large as Android.
We have a tool called Repo, which manages multiple Git repositories and lets people deal with them as a single unit. This is super important for Android because, in fact, we don't have just one source code repository. We have about 100 of them. We also have a web-based tool called Garrett, and this is what we use for source code reviews and for accepting patches and stuff like that. So if a developer wants to submit a patch back to the Android source code, they can use Garrett, they can submit their patch through it, and then the developer who works on that particular component will be able to see the code and comment on it and write a review, and there can be kind of a back and forth between the main, say like the lead for that component and the person submitting the patch. Once the patch looks good, you can just hit the button and it gets checked in, and then it becomes part of the open source project.
The Android open source project is ready for you to explore and contribute right now at source.android.com.
What will you do with Android?
What will you do with Android?